as I say it. I bear witness that there's nothing in existence worthy of worship but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is the servant and the messenger of Allah. If somebody says this with sincerity, they will become a Muslim. And that means this statement, that I no longer live a life according to how I want, but I declare, just like when I get married, I declare my fidelity and my absolute honor and respect towards my spouse. When I become a Muslim, I declare my loyalty and my obedience to the Creator. I acknowledge that I will no longer submit to myself, no longer submit to the evil around me, and I will do so by following the method taught to me by the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Some people may wonder, if Muslims really believe in all the messengers of God, why are they only mentioning Muhammad in their declaration of faith? Well, as Muslims believe in the oneness of God and in the unity of humankind, because there's no privilege for men over women or for whites over blacks, they also believe in the unity of the concept of prophethood. Muslims do not pick or choose. They believe in all the prophets. And the acknowledgement of the last prophet is an acknowledgement for all those who came before him. So the declaration of faith during the time of Abraham was like that. There is no God except Allah. Abraham is a messenger of Allah. During Moses, Moses is a messenger of Allah. During Jesus Christ, I bear witness there is no God except Allah. Jesus Christ is the messenger of Allah. And now Muhammad is a messenger of Allah. The acknowledgement of the last prophet is an acknowledgement for all those who came before him.
Whoever says this testimony with sincerity is to be considered a Muslim. And whoever dies on this belief will enter paradise if his sins were forgiven.
Becoming a Muslim does not give one a visa to paradise. The faith of Islam carries with it important responsibilities. This faith is represented by three important components. Number one, a sincere belief in the heart. Number two, the profession of this faith. And number three, following up this heart and this profession with sincere and virtuous actions. These important components of iman, or faith, is what makes a Muslim balanced and comprehensive in his outlook towards the world around him. It gives him a spiritual foundation, but at the same time encourages him to be a force of positivity in his community.
When people reflect upon the inner meaning of the testimony, they shall find liberation therein. It will break their chains. To believe that there is no God except Allah means that I will worship none but Allah. I will fear none but Allah. I will hope none but Allah. I will ask none but Allah. I will complain to none but Allah. I will love none but Allah and what Allah loves. I will dislike none but what Allah dislikes. He will be the core of my faith. It means that I will be no more the slave of any human or any material or any desire.
People are caught up in the flow of daily life. They move away from subjects to which they should actually turn their attention. They forget the true purpose of life. The daily prayers open communication channels with Allah and eradicate their heedlessness. Prayer ensures that the believer constantly turns to his Lord and establishes a powerful spiritual bond with God. It is revealed in the Quran that prayer reminds people of Allah and keeps them from all forms of evil. Recite that which has been revealed to you of the book and keep up prayer. Surely prayer keeps one away from indecency and evil. And certainly the remembrance of Allah is the most important thing, and Allah knows what you do.
When someone accepts Islam, I often tell them, guess what? The race is not over, but the race has just started. When someone accepts Islam, it doesn't mean that they can take a vacation and run to Disneyland. No, there are certain obligations which they must fulfill. And from those obligations is the important act of prayer. Everyone in the world knows that Muslims pray, and many people think that Muslims face the East. But if you see Muslims in China, they face the West. All of us face Mecca to observe these five important daily prayers. The Quran illustrates the importance of these prayers by showing that God Almighty has given the angels 2 wings and 3 wings and 4 wings. And for the human being who wants to soar to the obedience of Allah, just like these angels, God has given them 2 circuits of prayers, 3 circuits of prayers, and 4 circuits of prayer in a day. So just like the angels, our spiritual wings are found through observing this important act and mechanism known as Salah.
Muslims turn their faces towards Mecca when they pray, where a black cubicle building exists, which is called the Kaaba. The Kaaba is the first house of worship ever built on earth. It was built by Adam and then rebuilt by Abraham and his son Ishmael.
The Kaaba is not an idol that Muslims worship. Muslims believe that the Kaaba cannot do any benefit or any harm to anyone. The Kaaba is a center that unites Muslims around it in circles in the worship. And those circles keep on widening all over the earth. So when I pray individually, I still say, you alone we worship, and to you alone we turn for help. I don't say I worship or I turn for help, even though I am praying individually. And this is simply because I am not alone. I am in a circle. Other brothers and sisters are praying with me on that circle, maybe in China or in Denmark, maybe on a boat or on a mountain. But the Kaaba gives me the sense of universality of this religion by uniting Muslims around it in worship in circles.
Many people ask, and I've been asked this before, why do you guys put your face on the ground? What are you doing? What is this prostration? You know, this prostration, or sujood in the Arabic language, is not something new. If you look, for example, in the Christian New Testament, the book of Matthew, chapter 26, verse 39, you'll find Jesus described there as prostrating and beseeching his Lord for his bounties. In the Old Testament, we find the great prophets, such as Abraham, and Moses and David, peace be upon all of them, described as prostrating and beseeching their Lord. What this shows us is that Islam is not a new message. Islam is not the invention of Muhammad, peace be upon him. But Islam is the message of all of the prophets. And the prophecy of Muhammad is the culmination of that prophetic message. It represents the zenith of the prophetic message to humanity. Now, what I would like you to do is try to imagine a way that you would show your submission to God. What would you do? What act would you exhibit if you wanted to show your submission to God? Is there any greater act than the act of prostration? I challenge you to prostrate to your Creator. Malcolm X, a famous convert to Islam, said the most difficult thing he had to do when he became a Muslim was to destroy the arrogance in his soul and prostrate to his Lord. And he said the reason that it was difficult was not because of his arrogance, but he knew that once he prostrated to his Lord and he tasted the sweetness of that prostration and submission, he would never prostrate to anything else again.
And he, Jesus, went a little further and fell on his face and prayed. The Bible, Matthew 26:39.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
A Muslim is supposed to pay a financial obligation called zakah. All Muslims should spend 2.5% of their cash savings that were unused for a whole year on the poor, the needy, the homeless, and the orphans. In the early ages, zakah played a major role in freeing slaves. Muslims used it to buy slaves and free them.